Hi, welcome to the RV Corral website. My name is Jim Beckler. I'd like to take a few minutes to show you a brand new 2019 Keystone Cougar trailer. This is a 29BH model, so it's a nice bunkhouse layout. You'll like the way this thing lays out inside once we get a chance to go in and take a look, which we'll do here in just a minute. I'd like to cover a couple things on the outside first. And you probably have questions somewhere along the line that you can feel free to give me a call, 541-510-1017. That's my direct line. So if I miss something, feel free to let me know. You know, one of the things we really like about this product line is the fact that Keystone has some of the best-selling products in the marketplace. They have the, in fact, we carry four different lines of Keystone products. These, the Cougars, are, this is part of the half-ton series, so they're built here in Oregon. They're made in Pendleton. It's considered very higher-end quality. They actually can consider these a warrantied for full-time living. So if you're looking for something that you can use year-round, even though maybe you're not full-time RVer, you may want to invest in something that you know is going to be comfortable even if you're out in the colder or really hot weather. So they're 0 degree tested, anywhere from 0 degrees to 100 degrees. They're in that range. They've been tested to hold up. As long as you have your furnace on, you've got radiant heat, you got ways to keep this thing plenty safe and from the elements. You know, nice front design, newly designed front cap, solid one piece cap up here on the front, and then you do have the bottom part here has the protection from rock chips, that type of thing. This is metal. They went to this cap to, once they did that, they actually designed this so you could put a little bit longer bed in here. So instead of the shorter king size bed, the RV king, you can actually get an 80 inch long bed now. So that was one of the changes that they made in this model. We're going to take a look around the outside here, but notice the big storage area up front here. You got a big pass-through storage, aluminum frame construction. It's all welded. You can see the welds are all full welds, built really well, even finished out nicely inside. This has an in-command system, which we'll talk about this a little bit more when we get inside the trailer. But this is the housing of the meat and potatoes of that, so that you have access to be able to, you could actually, if you had to move your slide out in or something, or the awning, or there's ways you can do some of the controls by going directly to the power source here. Electric jacks, really nice, front and back are all electric, just push button. You've got a wiring already pre-wired for solar. So if you're a dry camper, you like to get off the beaten path, this, you can just plug in a little portable solar panel right there, help keep your batteries charged up. We're going to walk around the outside, but if you kind of scan down the side here, we'll go around the other side and come back around. But notice the big awning, nice LED light strip in there. Has an outside cook center down there, which we'll take a look at when we get around the other side. Just wanted to be able to see that this, because this is your patio side. This is where you'll be hanging out most of the time. And then the other side is kind of the work area, which we'll take a look over there here in just a sec. Electric tongue jack makes it much easier for loading and unloading. You'll be able to just push a button, raises up and lowers down without having to do all that cranking. Even has a light on the front, which is nice. And then you have LED light strips up here too, so if you're loading at night, you'll like having that. Two 7-gallon propane tanks, so you got the bigger propane tanks. We make sure they're full when you come to pick this up. We'll have two brand new batteries in battery covers up front there too, battery boxes. So the idea being that when you take possession of this, you're ready to go camp. We'll have a technician do a good orientation with you also. Other side of that pass-through storage, there's a light switch there, and then you do have a battery disconnect as well. So if I'm storing this, I can turn this disconnect on, and that way I'm not going to be drawing from my batteries, water hookups here, hot water heater, nice high fast recovery hot water heater. Notice the big slide out, nice deep slide. You'll notice once we get inside, it's really laid out well. You got your sewer hookups right here. This one does have your power cord stored right in here, so it's easy to get to. You don't have to try to find out where it was left the last time. It's always going to be right in there, easy to store. Take a look at this. This has a really nice little door to get into the back. This is your bunk area. This lifts up. I can lock this into place. So if I want to maybe slide some bicycles in there or use all this for storage, there's even room down in there for storage. So they've utilized the space really well in this. Kids will like having this too. They'll be able to look in outside. It is wired for a backup monitor. It has the pad for it. Doesn't come with that, but it is available. You can add that if you choose to do so. Walk ladder on the top to get up on top. It does have a one-piece walk-on roof. So again, your electric stabilizers. This one has two doors. I can get to my bathroom through this door, which makes it nice. The kids are out playing, you're inside the trailer. They don't have to run all the way through the trailer if they need to use a bathroom. Again, some nice awning. Outside shower, black tank flush. I can hook my pressured water to this here and keep my black tank sprayed out. Sprays out the inside of that. This is going to have hot and cold water as well. So, you know, it's a good source to be able to maybe spray off that sand. Maybe you've been in the beach or the pet maybe got a little bit muddy. That's part of your cook center here. It's got a nice grill, propane grill. Has its own propane hookup right under here, so I can just plug in to my propane right there. It runs off my main propane bottles, and that has a little outside refrigerator, also a small refrigerator. 110 outlets. Really nice, easy access door with the lend-a-hand. I like having these. It makes it much easier getting in and out. Very stable steps. So as we go inside, remember that if you have questions, give me a call. 541-510-1017. Come on in. Let's take a look here. Like I said, I think you really like the layout. Notice as you come in, right away you've got lots of storage. You've got some power outlets right there, one for 110. USB ports. Kitchen area has a good amount of counter space. Sink covers. Nice deep stainless steel sinks. It's nice having two sinks rather than just one for those of you that are going to be washing dishes. Obviously, you're going to do some of that. It's nice to be able to use soapy water and then be able to rinse without having to change your water. It even has a sprayer here, which makes it nice. So nice residential setup. Good amount of storage. Has the microwave plus the three burner stovetop. I like the fact that they've got again, utilizing the space, you can use that for extra counter space if you need it. But notice a nice three burner stovetop, larger propane oven. And then you've got storage back underneath here also. They use PEX piping in here so that you don't have problems with things freezing up. Lots of drawers, nice pull-out drawers. The refrigerator is gas electric. You have two-door, two-door being the freezer or separate from the refrigerator. It's an 8-cubic-foot refrigerator, so they went to a little bit larger refrigerator. Lots of nice convenient features. 15,000 watt or 15,000 BTU air conditioner. You have 35,000 BTU furnace, so it has really good heating and air conditioning. And again, it's not a entry-level type trailer. This thing is designed for somebody that's going to spend some time in it. Maybe you have a trailer now, you're looking to upgrade a little bit, but you still have, you know, the family's going to be camping with you a lot, so this will be a good layout, but just a cut above what some of the things that maybe you'll find out there on the market, especially due to the fact that it is insulated so well. Got a lot of storage under here. Up on top, more storage. Notice this big TV, and a nice large HD TV, 4K as a matter of fact. DVDs will play in this. You can slide in a CD if you want to listen to music. You have some USB port there as well. So there's, and it does play, it's an AM FM radio also. So you have full entertainment with speakers and everything on board. Here's that bathroom that we looked at from the outside. Porcelain toilet bowl, nice stand-up shower with a tub feature. Still got little ones that like to take a bath. You can put them in there and get them nice and clean before they turn in for the night. Notice the large bunks. You've got, really, these are big enough for two people. Two adults could sleep in these. So you got a lot of room. Windows on both of these. I'll have, again, power outlets on both. You have a USB port here. So you got a 110, looks like, up there also, and a little shelf. So, and a little ladder, built-in ladder to get up on top. Large slide out, we mentioned that on the outside. So you've got your trifold sleeper in here. This will actually make into a bed. So I can pull this out, make into another sleeper. So I really have this, which will sleep two people. I've got the dinette, which makes into a bed. I've got these two bunks, and then I have the bed up front, which we'll see here in just a minute. So you can definitely sleep a lot of people in here. Notice the really nice valances that they've used, and they're not just cheap curtains that they hang in here. So it's a good, better finish. Lots of lighting inside of the slide out. You do have a dimmer switch for that too, so if you want to dim the lights a little bit, you can do that, or brighten them up, depending on, you know, what your mood is or what you're thinking at the particular time. Big windows in the slide outs too. Notice all the windows, large windows on the side of the slide out, which many times they're not that big, and a lot of manufacturers will put windows in here that won't open up, so both these will open up, so you'll be able to get a lot of airflow through here. Again, I mentioned this makes into another sleeper. And then you've got additional storage under here. Metal glides, so you can put some weight in there. You don't have to worry about the thing falling out on you. And you've got a good dinette area. Check out this pantry. Got a huge pantry. Lots of room in there. It even has a rod up there where you can hang stuff in there if you want to hang some shirts or whatever, and a light as well. Now, I mentioned, we pointed out down below that the in-command center, this is the controls inside the trailer for that. So if I had batteries in it, which you notice out in front, it doesn't, so I can't really demonstrate this, but when I go to the house, which this has it's coded too, so with a security code, so you can put your own 4-digit code. It's nothing too complicated to be able to access this. So, you know, nobody's going to play with this if you don't want them to. Maybe you got kids that like to maybe monkey with stuff. You don't have to worry about that if they don't have the code. But I can go to this screen, check out all of the different items here, kind of get an idea what I can access. I can change climate controls, awnings. I can adjust settings. I can actually, even with this system, if I wanted to program this like your thermostat at home, I can have different settings. Like if I'm out during the day and I want the air conditioner to be a little higher, run a little bit more, I want my temperature down a little bit more, I can adjust that, and then maybe in the evening time I can program this to go at a little higher temperature, so you have different comfort levels. Lighting, slide outs, all the electrical, I can access my check my batteries, water pump I can turn on from here, water heater, lighting, and so on and so forth. It also has a feature that you can use to download your this whole program into your smartphone. So if you have a smartphone, you can use your smartphone to do pretty much everything that we can do on this panel right here. So I can use my smartphone, I can access this, I can go to the panel down below and be able to operate things within, you know, this trailer. It's really nice too having that. If you have a smartphone, you can put that on your phone, and that way if you're outside, you could be in there changing the temperature. You wouldn't even have to come inside to do that. You could kick the awning out, you know, just lots of controls are right at your fingertips. I mentioned this is a 0-degree tested coach. Here you have heated holding tanks. So I have 12 volt holding tanks, fully enclosed underbelly, so I have radiant heat down there. I have a heat duct that's going to blow hot air down in there, and then these are insulated beyond the whole the 12 volt pads that are on there. It has that your holding tanks have insulation on them as well. So really they've taken the time to make this a unit that you can be in year round and be comfortable. What's nice about this is you can be traveling down the highway. If you are traveling in some cold weather, I could put these heat pads to my tanks because it's running off your 12 volts. So your vehicle that you're pulling this with is charging up your batteries, which are going to allow you to run this system. So you've got heated holding tanks the whole time you're traveling. That way you wouldn't have to worry about running your propane furnace to be able to keep heat down there. As I mentioned, they're also insulated too, apart from this. So really, they've made this thing pretty bulletproof when it comes to that. I mean, anything's possible. If you don't have your furnace on, then, you know, and you have water and you're in some cold weather, then, you know, you may have some problems with things freezing up on you. But they've designed this so that you don't have to if you do the necessary things to be able to avoid that. It does have a panel here that where you can go to have Furrion access, which enhances your Wi-Fi capability. It gives you basically a router in-house. So if you choose to have that, you could go with a system like that. I mentioned the nice big bed. Look, it's a king size bed. I think it's 70 by 80. So you got a good size bed. Notice you've got nightstands on both sides too, with 110 outlets and power ports on each side. You have some hanging closet space there on both sides of the bed. A little bit of storage up here. I can walk around the bed. Storage up on top. And a ton of storage underneath here. Lots of storage. Notice you do have windows on both sides here, two exit windows, which I can use to let in a little bit of fresh air if I wanted to do that as well. Like on a day like today, it's supposed to be about 90. We're having a little bit of warm weather for Eugene. So yeah, hey, this is the time of year, so give me a call. This will be a great trailer for you if you want something that's, like I said, a cut above, but still something that you can put the family in and everybody's going to be comfortable. You can reach me at 541-510-1017. Just ask for Jim. Thanks.